Okay, so good evening, everyone. So it's my pleasure to introduce Haruzo Hida from UCLA, and he's going to speak about local p-indecomposability of modular Galois representations.
Thank you. So let me start with Caspar. Of course, it's an eigenform. Elliptic modular. Then you have a Galois representation rho f at p. Prime p is all the time supposed to be perhaps bigger than 2. Okay, so odd prime. So it's a Galois group of q bar over q into GL2 of qp bar. And of course, it factors through some discrete variation ring A inside this, ADBR. And I often write rho bar for rho FP modulo maximal ideal of A. So it's a Galois representation into GL2 of a finite field F. That is a finite extension of FP. Okay, so I consider the ordinary case. So the rho FP restricted to decomposition group, P decomposition group, is upper triangular, and you have a co-cycle here. UF is a co-cycle from DP to the character, the space of character, epsilon F delta F inverse, one co-cycle. I'm quite interested in to study this one. Getting the co-cycloid image, actually. And UF, of course, in the ordinary case, if I assume that this, therefore, rho bar is also epsilon bar, zero delta bar, something, U bar. But if epsilon bar, I usually assume this, but delta bar inverse is not one, so epsilon bar different from delta. This U or UF is having values in p-profinite group, so it factors through. I mean, Frobenius is usually semi-simple, so factors through the wild inertial group. So I have wild inertial, p inertial, inside the inertial group and dp I have. And so therefore I want to study when rho f restricted to I is indecomposable or non-split. Okay, so of course you can replace this by IP if you want, or DP also, but it's the same thing. So this is the question. And obviously there's a Greenberg's, I mean, this was first remarked by Greenberg's, so it is called Greenberg's conjecture, that this rho f I non-split, as long as f non-CM, so not an induced representation from imaginary quadratic field, and weight k is bigger than or equal to 2. Okay, so let's try to give some sort of survey at the beginning that what kind of things is known. So for example, if elliptic curve is corresponding to F, so F is a weight two and integer coefficients. Slightly more generally, I take V over number field K. Then I suppose this has ordinary good reduction over some P, prime P over P. And then you have a EU extend scalar to width vectoring of the width vectoring of algebraic closure of FP, and then you reduce module of P, that's E bar. Then you know the deformation space of this DE bar. It's just an elliptic curve over the width vector ring, such that you cut it to the P fiber and it is isomorphic to E bar. Then this is isomorphic as a space to 1 plus maximal ideal. So maximal ideal with this width vector ring. This is Seyart-Tate theory. Let me just slightly more down to us. I do. So I have a Galois representation law E acting on the Tate module of E. Then this is ordinary good reduction, so law E of the decomposition group at this Gaussian P is epsilon E, zero delta E, and UE, as I said, something like already. And this is elliptic curve, so the epsilon E restricted to I, the inertial group, is a cyclotomic character, p-adic. And of course, this is the P square. So this co-cycle UE modulo P to the N is a Kummer co-cycle because this is a cyclotomic character modulo P to the N, so the action of P power roots of unity. So it contains some P to the nth root of unity, P to the nth root of one unit, I should say. And you pass to the limit you get U corresponding to E. And the Seyart-Tate theory tells you that, so the deformation space, this one plus M is just a one line. So this is, if you want, you can write GM hat in formal group, WFP bar, if you want. Then you have a identity here, and you have another thing. And this identity element contains CM elliptic curve, a CM by an order. Of an imaginary quadratic field maximal at P. That's a unique CM elliptic curve sitting whose order is maximal at P. And so if U is non-zero, it's sitting somewhere. This corresponds to E. So non-CM E has non-split rho E. Okay, so this is a remark on say a long, long ago. But actually, you can extend it to a Abelian variety. Of the L2 type. That is very difficult, actually. The L2 type Abelian variety means that endomorphism of the Abelian variety, it is defined over number field, but I consider the absolute endomorphism over Q bar. So that is an integer ring. Of number field. And the rank, this degree of this field is equal to dimension of A. So the Tate module of Gossick P R prime over P of this O is just isomorphic to OP square. So you get a GR2 representation. You have still a deformation theory, you have all deformation, you consider deformation space, same way you define, then this is isomorphic to, by the same Kummer-Kocycle business, but you need to add the information of endomorphism, so that you need to tensor O. That is just a product, now over P, dividing P of your your endomorphism field, I'm sorry, P dividing P of 1 plus N tensor now the P of O Gossick P. So the picture is something like that. For example, if field of fraction of O is real quadratic field, and P split in two pieces, something like that, then you have a two axis, Cosec P axis and Cosec P conjugate axis, right? And for example, if your Abelian variety is somehow sitting here, this means the coordinate P coordinate is one, I mean, one is zero, this is one actually. So PP A on which the representation act rho P, and this has to be split. But only this point is the maximal at PCN. So you have a trouble, right? So this is the problem. And theorem I proved long ago, not so long, myself, so Journal of American Math Society, 2013, and my student, Pinjiao. This is very popular name in China. A lot of Pinjiao exists, but anyway, is that rho P acting on TPA is non-split as long as A non-CM and ordinary, of course. So this tells you that if weight is 2, and F non CM, then rho FP non split without any condition. I proved this when A is defined over K and O is totally real. And K and O unramified at P. And so this is my result. And Jobin proved this on any DL2 type without any ramification condition. Idea is just kind of simple. I have these two coordinates. So this axis essentially, this is inside Hilbert modular simulable ID. Because the totally real case, this type of abelian variety is parameterized, modularized, Hilbert modular variety. And with respect to Shimura variety, this axis is essentially rational. That's I do. I mean, tangentially rational, I would say. Then you move around the prime. Then you can have an inner prime. Then only one axis and apply C as well. Although this is very important proof, not so easy, but anyway, so that's how things go. Okay, so question is, how about higher weight? Okay, bigger than two, if you want. Now, I sort of use a deformation theory, Galois deformation. Only things you can do is perhaps this one. You move your cusp form to higher weight gradually, periodically, and try to show something. And so I consider the functor from complete local W algebra. Now W is a width vector ring finite over this F, the residual representation coefficient into sets, such that you plug in a ring A, then you get a row. Before doing that, I need to make some simplifying assumption. I have Q and I have a splitting field of rho bar. So the Galois group is isomorphic to image of rho bar. Then I take a maximal P profinite extension. The condition is here that it is unramified outside P. So I limit ramification over this finite. In this finite extension, anything can ramify, but after that, it is unramified outside P and the Galois group G. And I consider the deformation over this Galois. So for example, the elliptic gap with split multiplicative reduction somewhere outside P is kind of kicked out, because then I need to consider that ramification only, and it makes things quite complicated. So the deformation functor is just a row from this G into GL2A as usual, such that row modulo maximal ideal is rho bar up to isomorphism. Okay, then this is represented under the condition epsilon bar different from delta bar. I mentioned at the beginning. This is represented for some universal ring exists here. And often nowadays, almost all cases, but it is, you have a Heck algebra T. So this is, I assume R equal T theorem. So this is a hypothesis, but most cases true. T is a Heck algebra. So you pick lambda, then you have a universal representation of T of G into GL2 of T, and this goes to lambda specialized, you specialize rho T to lambda, and then this way, this is isomorphic. Okay. So, this T is known to be free of finite rank over lambda. Lambda is a universal algebra. Now I should say rho T is a universal character. Whatever you make maneuver, often there you get a universal object out of this rho T, deforming that rho bar over G, okay? And this induces, in particular, rho T restricted dp is as usual epsilon T zero delta T ut. And this is unnormified. So this epsilon is local universal character. So epsilon T, say restricted to gamma, that is a Galois group of, so I take Galois group of cyclotomic ZP extension. This subjects down to gamma, the maximal people finite quotient. And this is isomorphic to one unit by cyclotomic character, p-adic cyclotomic character. Okay, so in particular, this epsilon, because of universality, over inertial group, the determinant is just this epsilon, right? Delta is unnormified. So you plug in, say one plus pqp, the wild inertial element, Artin symbol, then you get T. T is what? T is in the Iwasawa algebra ZP double bracket T. And this is one plus capital T. In other words, epsilon T of gamma group is T to the ZP. This is a generator. Okay? So here is a topic I talked about in RTZ talk, local one generator theory. It's something like that. You have rho T, you plug in inertia group, right? Then wild inertia, then you get T to the ZP, one and something here. This U is a unipotent element. Well, you can write this U going into rho TI, getting out to TZP, you get the exact sequence. You get the Iwasawa module U. U is a, first of all, it acts, T acts by conjugation. So it becomes lambda module. Because lambda is also a group ring, completed group ring of gamma, right? Classical recursive resetting. It also acts Frobenius. And you can, so I call it phi, but you can normalize phi so that rho phi is something AA inverse 0, 0. So conjugation, by conjugation of this unipotent part, it acts by A square. So lambda, you add A square. So this lambda module, you have further the action. You have this epsilon bar zero, delta bar zero. This acts by conjugation. Of course, you can just take a Teichmuller lift. You get a epsilon zero, zero delta. So it acts by epsilon delta inverse. That of course has a, is a character of F rho bar over Q to a valuation ring W cross, right? So I need, this lambda is ZP coefficient, but I now, therefore at the end, you just take W to be subalgebra of, this is not lambda. Epsilon delta inverse. So the subring generated by the values of epsilon delta inverse. That I just write W. Then hereafter, I actually lambda W, I take the W double bracket to T, but often, at just lambda, just to, my electronic pen doesn't use any ink, but to save ink. This U is lambda A square module. And theorem, essentially theorem of Iwasawa, but he didn't know this rho t kind of things, but anyway, tells you that U is a cyclic module over this. In other words, U is lambda A square times some theta for some theta in T. Okay, there's a one generator in this U. This one generator thing is very specific to cyclotomic theory. If you take non-cyclotomic ZP extension, that's not true. That also is not true. But so the universality is quite important here. Okay. So now this T, or maybe spectrum of T, is a union of CM component and of non-CM component. This is just a union of CM irreducible component. I mean, Galois representation projected down TCM is an induced representation from imaginary quadratic. Usually T is equal to T non-CM, but your residual representation is induced from imaginary quadratic, which you have this TCM, okay? And obviously, the rho T of I is therefore TZP theta times lambda A square one, right? So therefore, obviously, theta projected to TCA is zero, so theta is T non-CA. And this Jauze's theorem, weight two theorem, tells you that this is a non-zero device. This T is a reduced ring, free of finite rank over lambda. Okay, so so this means
excuse me, yes. Does this follow from result of Vatsal and Gatte?
Vatsal Gatte proved when residual representation is induced representation. This is any residual representation. Okay. All right, so because it's a non-zero divisor, so for all lambda in spectrum of T non-CM, you evaluated QP bar, the associated Galois representation rho lambda restricted I is non-split. So non-zero divisor by virus loss preparation theorem, there's only finitely many zeros over this spectrum. So this is the consequence. Okay. So let's go on. Now I just give you one example where I can prove that the Greenberg's conjecture without any exception. So it is something about global one generator theorem. Okay, I consider a joint rho bar. So this is Galois representation into GL2 of real algebra of SL2. Okay, so it's just a trace zero matrix goes to conjugation. And I have Q, I have now F splitting field of F add rho bar. This is slightly smaller than F rho bar. And I have F, and I have Galois group GF. This is G, something like that, picture F. Okay. So, here's a theorem. I consider the cross group of F, this adjoint splitting field. And I cut it over the group algebra. So this Galois group, I just write capital G over joint rho bar. Often I write CLF, isotypic component of a joint rho bar. So if CLF a joint rho bar is zero, so the if class number is prime to P, it's okay. And epsilon bar delta bar inverse. So this is a decomposition group can character is not equal to the cyclotomic character modulo P. Then the number of generator of T over lambda is less than equal to 1. This number I call R. It's easy, so I have still 20 minutes or something. So I try to prove this. This R by general nonsense is dimension over F of Selmer group of adjoint robot. Okay. A Selmer group is something over M adjoint rho bar is just a kernel of H1 of this G. You take a Galois group over M. M is a given field. I'm specializing to F actually. Two, product over primes of M of H1 of decomposition group modulo F plus minus H1 dp. This is just spanned by 1 core cycle upper unipotent, upper nilpotent, over inertial group, and upper triangular decomposition group. This is not being gossip. I should say that this is after conjugation. I mean, your representation restricted to D cosec P may not be upper triangular, but up to conjugation upper triangular. In this sense, this I apply. And another remark is only this condition is very important. Usually the second condition follows from the first, but anyway, sometimes not, so I just went this way. So I need to count this dimension, and it's kind of easy. You restrict to F. Remember, this is a splitting field of adjoint rule. So the first of Selmer group over F add rho bar, and you have a fixed by Galois group G. G is the Galois group of F over Q. Okay. And of course, inside you have Selmer group over Q of adroba. This dimension, this is a question mark object. Then you have every Fourier unramified core cycle. And by local class fields, its theory, it gets out this is exact. And I assume that this is zero, right? Here, O is an integer ring. OP is just an O tensor ZP, and OP cross hat is a P profinite completion. Something like that. Now, That's a punchline. This is isomorphic to, because I assume the rho bar restricted to dp is split. Epsilon bar zero, delta bar zero. So it's a tamely ramified. And therefore this guy is just induced as a G module, Z bracket Z module, from one to entire Z of trivial representation. So it is just a group algebra. So this is by Shapiro. It is just a form, I lose everything, Z action of Zp of Adro bar. And this pi is a projection map, and pi server M is upper nilpotent. So it's dimension one, because it's a adjoint has upper nilpotent one, dimension one. So this above guy dimension one, so the bottom guy less than dimension. I should say that this is injective because H1 of our joint vanishes. However, H2 of our joint could be non-trivial. For example, if our joint, if rho bar has image containing SL2 or something. So I can't say this is isomorphism. Okay, so this is a proof. So here's a question. For fixed F, are there infinitely many splitting primes, split primes for rho bar? Rho bar depends on P, yeah? This is a rho F P mod P C. So when spread, it looks like there should be infinitely many. And of course, weight one case, almost all satisfy this. But CM case, of course, so when the weight is non-CM case, the question mark. If yes, this CLF tensor Adro for almost all split F, split P, split means this residual representation is split over inertia. I mean, if this guy is isomorphism, if this is isomorphism, then this would be true because adjoint guy is zero for almost, bottom guy is zero for almost all. But I can't prove this stupidly. So this is another question. Okay, so an example. Of course, weight one case, this stuff is true by stupid reason. So I take rho bar to be induced representation from Q, now real field, to okay. And I just write phi the time lift. So weight to one case, this is an outing representation. Okay, so the compatible system is one element unique, this induced representation of Y essentially. Now, there's a one thing is that this is induced, so rho bar, you take a quadratic residue symbol of this quadratic field, then rho bar, your tensor alpha, is isomorphic to rho bar. If you take standard form of matrix form of induced representation, you just multiply alpha, then this is 1 minus 1, rho bar 1 minus 1, stupid. But I use this stupid factor. So you have dt, right? You pick a universal guy, you send it to the tensor plotter. Then it's returned to dt, right? Because tensor doesn't change residual. So this gives an involution, iota. Iota is an involution, automorphism t over lambda. And if f with k member bigger than 2 of this deformation thing, then of course rho f is not a theta series, it's a real quadratic. They are different. So iota is non-trivial. T is different from bigger than lambda. Therefore, number of generator, if say CLQ or CLF, now I should say F is just independent of P. A joint of induced representation of phi is alpha direct sum induced representation of anti-cyclotomic thing. So it's just a phi g, phi sigma g sigma inverse. Sigma is just an element of g such that sigma square root of d goes to minus square root of d. Non-trivial on the real quadratic field. So it's independent. So therefore most for all more. So if, for example, if p doesn't divide the class number of f, then of course CLF is just zero. And it's mostly true. So all the conditions I made. So the under these circumstances, dt is generated by one element, big theta. So I can write lambda polynomial ring with the characteristic polynomial of theta. I mean, d is x goes to theta times x. All right. And you can assume, of course, iota theta is minus theta because this iota theta is square root of something. Yeah. Okay. So under these circumstances, theorem is like that. It's real quadratic with integer ring unit group is generated by a fundamental unit. Right? And this, I suppose that P is split to make naturally ordinary. Of course, in that case, it's also ordinary, but I just suppose this condition. Then I just, now I write O for this one. Then OP is just a ZP. So I have cross. And then I project down to gamma. I have epsilon. It goes to bracket epsilon. I consider this in lambda. Then this is T to the log epsilon, p-adic log, log of 1 plus p, something like that. Okay. And I remark that cross group of q square root of d only ramified half of p. You take p profinite completion, then this is just gamma over epsilon to the z. So it is gamma over gamma to the p to the m. M is a p order of epsilon p minus one because it's a p profinite projection. M is something like that. All right. So theorem here is that under these circumstances, this inertia generator, first of all, inertia generator divide this epsilon minus one inside T. Number one. Number two, therefore, this is just so the ideal generated by the epsilon prime factor of epsilon minus one is just a P is generated by T minus zeta kind of things. Zeta to the PM is one, this M, okay? So it's a weight one prime. Therefore, rho F inside this deformation of weight K bigger than two, maybe I just make a general A, is non-split over I, the inertia group, without any assumption. Weight two, then this avoid weight one prime. Number three, if number of generator is one, this ideal theta generated by theta is equal to ideal generated by big theta. I have still 5 minutes. I try to explain why this is the case. I just assume P doesn't divide HF. Otherwise, the proof is very important. Then I consider the different. I have T and subring fixed by iota, so T, where iota is one. Then you have lambda, right? Then I have a different T, iota minus one. I consider rho, that is rho T, modulo this different. Then iota, this is rho tensor alpha, is actually rho because modulo different iota is trivial. So rho is induced representation of some character phi. And this is, rho T is universal, so phi is actually universal. This phi, universal character, deforming 5 bar and ramified outside essentially cosine. Okay, that means if I write, we go back a little bit. If I write C for this group, okay, this is the Galois group of class fields that ramified outside Gossic P, P class field. And that is gamma over gamma P to the M or gamma to the epsilon to the Z. And therefore, funny things happen. T modulo different. Oh, by the way, theta iota is minus theta as I have chosen. So the different is principal generated by theta. So T modulo theta is a universal ring of this Galois group C. And this is lambda modulo epsilon minus, right? I'm just repeating this identity. On the other hand, this is lambda x of x dx because theta is the root of x. So this is lambda modulo d0. So d0 ideal is this epsilon minus one. So theta, big theta divide epsilon minus. I have 2 minutes. And the point here is that you remember rho bar multiplied alpha is 1 minus 1 rho bar, 1 minus 1 inverse. Out of that, iota rho t is 1 minus 1 rho t times alpha 1 minus 1. Ah, I'm sorry. This is rho t product alpha. Is 1 minus 1, something like that. Okay? Therefore, this tells you that rho t over your imaginary, your real quadratic field has values in generalized matrix algebra representation. T minus is T where iota acts by minus one. So it is actually theta T plus. And this shoulder UT modulo, so it has values in T minus, okay? You model out by, it is theta. Oh, by the way, I forgot one more thing. I ran out of time, so just a couple of minutes perhaps. So this is theta times T plus. And rho I is T to the ZP, lambda A square, small theta, 0, 1. So small theta is T minus. So theta is big theta times some element in U plus. Then this co-cycle modulo theta T minus theta times U, that is small theta, plus maximal ideal is this is just isomorphic to the class group of Fi minus. But this is zero, I assume P doesn't divide. I should say. I should say CLF Adroba tensor Adroba. But strictly speaking, this is just a CLF phi minus tensor phi minus. And this is zero. I assume this guy is zero. So theta is capital theta. U is a unit. Maybe the last part is a little fast, but this is the end of the story. Sorry, I exceeded 2 minutes.
Okay, thank you very much. So are there any questions?
Just one question. What can you say specifically about delta?
Please repeat.
I mean, delta, the Ray 12 eigenform.
Would you tell me again? It's a little connection is bad.
Sorry. I'm wondering about the form delta, specific eigenform. Delta, the Ray 12.
Oh, delta. Lamarjat delta.
As the prime p varies. Can you say that? Very interesting or important.
So the Lamarjat delta case, it's not a. Lamarjat delta case, I think Gatte and Butter proved this kind of indecomposability. I think for all, I guess. As long as it becomes a split modulo P. Otherwise, it's of course indecomposable. Maybe they have some other conditions, but for one form, yeah. Is it fine?
Any other question? So the condition that P does not divide the class number of F is crucial here.
Oh, for my dad, this argument. But actually, I have this lambda now small theta inside T. Then I can basically prove, so this small theta all the time exists. It's just a Iwasawa's theorem. So it's characteristic polynomial dx. So I just write lambda x modulo dx. Then the d0 is idr is epsilon minus one. That I can prove, but argument is very involved. Not very, but a kind of commutative algebra argument I need to do. So the only things important is this theta, right, for the indecomposability concern. So it works without this class number condition. But the interesting point is that this small theta and big theta is quite close, even that case. I think that the if you climb up to the cyclotomic ZP extension, Heck algebra may grow, but perhaps doesn't grow too much. This theta survives and the Frobenius A survives, so it could be two variable, possibly up to two variable. So this theta kind of things is interesting. This big theta is also interesting to know. I mean the just for structure theory of universe only.
And so what happened in the situation where you take an Hilbert modular form now? If you assume that P splits, for instance?
Hilbert modular case, the Hilbert modular case.
The Wasserwas theorem is
the for example, if you take K over F, something real called real totally real quadratic extension, right? Then the number of generator of T over lambda is usually the degree of F cube. Because you have this amount of independent unit, this F bracket epsilon minus one kind of thing. So the one generator theorem won't be true. But this Heck algebra has a sort of Galois action of F over Q, and that sort of permutes that unit. So it might be the case that if you somehow cut it by this Galois action, it still works. So the main idea is that this theta, as long as T is different from lambda, then this theta divides a joint L value of a joint L p-adic L function of this universal object. If this is the true, this Greenberg's conjecture works. I mean, or, because a joint L value never vanishes at classical point. If T is lambda, you can't do that, but then you base change to some layer Qn over Q, cyclotomic tower, cyclotomic layer, then the lambda will be replaced by the P double bracket T to the P to the N minus one. It shrinks. So therefore, you get into T different from lambda situation. And if one analyzes very well this kind of things, perhaps Greenberg's conjecture would be solved. I hope so.
So you mentioned the Greenberg's conjecture for abelian varieties of GL2 type. Is yes. there a generalization of Greenberg's conjecture for more general abelian varieties?
Possibly, but there's a several kind of formulation you have. For example, if you suppose endomorphism of A over Q bar is Z or something, then your inertia is something TZP, then one here, and you have some unipotent there, right? So you can't have really, I think that you can't have really the root, rather degenerate root only show up. But still it could be indecomposable. And then you need to study the deformation ring of this, that is GM of WFP, deformation space, tensor, this symmetric matrix. If genus, the dimension is Z, symmetric D by D matrix, this is a deformation ring. And you need to analyze, you have a lot of axes. So the at least my argument, I thought about genus 2 case and it's still having a trouble. One needs some more input, I think.
Okay, I see, thank you.
Okay, any more questions? Okay, so if no more questions, then let's thank you. I was all.
Thank you. Bye-bye. So see you sometime after COVID is over.